Good morning, everybody. Today, let us start a new chapter in the literature, that is, The Fun They Had. This is related to the school and the teaching mode. This story was written by Isaac Asimov, who was a very famous writer. He always wanted the readers to imagine to the future world about computers and robots. His popular works are Nightfall Foundation, Second Foundation, The Caves of Steel, and The End of Eternity. In this chapter, we will be seeing how the teaching has been done by the robots. It has In the future time, the teacher will be taking place by the robots. Now, let us come on to the explanation of the chapter. Nowadays, you can see that you are getting your education at your home because of the lockdown. The same story may prevail in the future, that the student will not go to the school, rather they will be taught by the mechanical teacher, or you, as you can say, by the robots. Here we will study a story of the future generation. Now, Maggie even wrote about it that night in her diary. Maggie has the habit of writing diary every night. So she wrote one day what she wrote on the page headed 17 May 21,055. Means it is, we are talking about the future time. Okay. And what she wrote: today Tommy found a real book. Tommy is her brother. And she wrote on it in her diary that today Tommy found a real book, means they all got a book, a real book. Now, what is the story about it? It was very old book. Maggie's grandfather once said that when he was a little boy, his grandfather told him that there was a time when all stories were printed on paper. Now, these children have not seen books, that is paper. They all are being educated by the robots, so it was very strange to them. Now Maggie, she once remembered that when the grandfather was a little boy, he has told that he was being taught by the books only, where the stories were printed on paper. Now they turned the page, which were yellow and crinkly, and it was awfully, the pages of the book was yellow in color because it was very old, isn't it? And it was also wrinkled. They have found the book which was very old. They turned the pages which were yellow and crinkly, and it was awfully funny to read words that stood still instead of moving the way they were supposed to on the screen. Now these two children were accustomed to study where the words were moving, isn't it? The words were always moving in the screen because they were studying in the computer-based school. So the screen words were going on moving. वाइल इन द बुक द वर्ड्स वेर कॉन्स्टेंट, इट वॉज देयर स्टिल. सो इट वॉज वेरी मच फनी फॉर देम टू सी सच टाइप ऑफ बुक्स, यू नो. एंड देन वेन दे टर्न बैक टू द पेजेस बिफोर, इट हैड द सेम वर्ड ऑन इट दैट इट हैड वेन दे रीड इट इन द फर्स्ट टाइम. मीन्स द बुक्स वेर हैविंग द स्टिल वर्ड्स, द वर्ड्स वेर नॉट चेंज इन द नंबर ऑफ पेजेस, वाइल इन द कंप्यूटर दे यूज टू चेंज आफ्टर वन स्क्रीन टू अनदर. गी सेड टॉमी, व्हाट अ वेस्ट. व्हेन यू आर थ्रू विथ अ बुक यू जस्ट थ्रो इट अवे आई गेस. आर टेलीविजन स्क्रीन मस्ट हैव हैड अ मिलियन बुक ऑन इट एंड इट्स गुड फॉर प्लेंटी मोर, आई वुडंट थ्रो इट अवे. नाउ टॉमी ही सेड दैट व्हाट इज अ वेस्ट, मीन्स having a book is a waste according to him. He says that in our screen, that is in his television screen, lots and lots of books are there and one can read it and finish it, while in the book if we read once, according to him it is of waste. So he feels that it is better to have a or better to read books in the television screen where they are having millions and millions of stories in it. Same with mine, said Maggie. She was 11 and hadn't seen as many telly books as Tommy had. He was 13. So she was of 11 years and she hadn't seen any of the books as Tommy had seen or read. She said, where did you find it? In my house. So she said, where did you find it? In my house. The book was in his house. He pointed without looking because he was busy reading in the attic. Attic is what? It is a room on the top of the building. Okay. So he was reading that book and he told that the book was found in his house. What's it about? Now what is written in that book? School. Something was written about the school. Maggie was scornful school. She was very much, she doesn't like school. So she said that, school, what's there to write about school? I hate school. The mechanical teacher had been giving her test after test in geography and she had been doing worse and worse until her mother had shaken her head sorrowfully and sent for the county inspector. Now, Maggie hated school because she was being taught by the mechanical teachers or the robot, and the robots always used to take test every time, and in geography she was not giving Maggie was not able to get good score in her geography section. And she was doing worse and worse. So, mother took the mechanical teacher as well as Maggie to the county inspector. He was round. County inspectors are whom? County inspectors are those who manages the mechanical teacher or assemble or whatever problem if there is, they manages it. They are known as county inspector. Okay. He was a round little man with a red face and a whole box of tools with dial and wires. Means he was having full kit with him to detect whatever mistake if any of the mechanical teachers are having. He smiled at her and gave her an apple, then took the teacher apart. He smiled at Maggie, and gave her an apple to eat and took the teacher apart means to test whatever wrong in that part of it. Margie had hoped he wouldn't know how to put it together again. Miss Margie was so much fed up with the mechanical teacher that she wanted that if this robot is not taken apart, then might be this man will not be able to assemble it once again. So she was feeling that maybe that robot will not move back again to her house. But he knew how to set it all right, and after an hour or so, there it was again, large and black and ugly, with a big screen on which all the lessons were shown and the questions were asked. Now Margie was thinking that might be that quantity inspector would not be able to assemble it again, but within an hour he assembled it with all as it was before, and she was very much upset to see the mechanical teacher once again back to her. That wasn't so bad. The part she hated most was the slot where she had to put homework and test paper. Margie hated what? She hated that where she used to have to put her homework daily and where she used to give her test. She always had to write them out in a punch code. They made her learn when she was 6 years old, and the mechanical teacher calculated the marks in no time. Means she used to give the test and within you can say a minute or so, she used to get the answer back. So she didn't like such type of tests or the homeworks given to her. The inspector had smiled after he was finished and patted her head. He said to her mother, "It's not the little girl's fault, Mrs. Jones. I think the geography sector was geared a little too quick." So what happened? There was some problem. The geography sector was little geared, means it was being put little ahead. That is why she was unable to manage the test. So see, he told that it was not the fault of Margie. It was the fault of the mechanical teacher only, because the geography sector was little geared to a high level. "Those things happen sometimes. I have slowed it up to an average 10-year level. Actually, the overall pattern of her progress is quite satisfactory." And he patted Margie's head again. He told to Mrs. Jones that these all things happen because these all are the mechanical things, and sometimes it get little geared too quick or less. So he said that he has put it in an average level of the 10 years student, and everything will be now satisfactorily. And he patted Margie's head once again. Margie was disappointed. Why she was disappointed? Because she again had to go back home and face the mechanical teacher. She had been hoping that they would take the teacher away altogether. They had once taken Tommy's teacher away for nearly a month because his history sectors had blanked out completely. Margie thought that maybe she will not get back this mechanical teacher again back to her home, because once she remembered that Tommy's teacher has been taken away and it has taken about 1 month because the history sector was totally blanked in it. So she also wanted that maybe she will get rid of the mechanical teacher from her also. So she said to Tommy, "Why would you anyone write about school?" So she was very much queried that why anyone will write about school. Schools are so frustrating. Schools are so boring that every time giving test, every time giving homeworks, it's too much for her. So she says that why someone writes about the school. Tommy looked at her with very superior eyes, because it's not our kind of school, stupid. This is the old kind of school that they had hundreds and hundreds of years ago, he added loftily, pronouncing the words carefully, centuries ago. Now Tommy was reading in that book was about the school which was running a century ago. And what kind of school was that? That's old kind of schools, which used to be going on centuries ago. That is the school. And Margie was hurt. Well, I don't know what kind of school they had all that time ago. She read the book over her shoulder for a while, then said, anyway, they had a teacher. Now, she didn't knew what type of schools were running a century ago. She asked that whether there was a teacher also over there. Sure, they had a teacher, but it wasn't regular teacher. It was a man. Now, Margie was very much surprised to hear this, that at that time, there was not only one teacher who used to teach. It was taught by different teachers. It was man who was giving lessons to the student, not the mechanical one. A man, how could a man be a teacher? Well, he just told the boys and girls things and gave them homework and asked them questions. A man isn't smart enough. Sure he is. My father knows as much as my teacher. He can't. A man can't know as much as a teacher. He knows almost as much, I bet. Now both of them have difference in views about the teacher as a man can be a teacher or not. Margie was very much confused that how can a man teach a student? A man don't have such knowledge that a mechanical teacher is having. But Tommy assured her that a man can also be a teacher, a man can also be a knowledgeable person and can teach the children's more satisfactorily than a mechanical teacher. Margie wasn't prepared to dispute that. She said, I wouldn't want a strange man in my house to teach me. Now, Margie was very much, you can say, confused that how can a man teach any of the students. So she says that how it will be very much strange that a man is coming to me and he is giving me knowledge or teaching me. Tommy screamed with laughter, shouted with laughter. You don't know much, Margie. The teacher didn't live in a house. They had a special building and all the kids went there. Now Tommy explained her that it is not that a man is going to come to your house and teach you. It is a school where each and every student used to go there. It is a, you can say, a building where each and every student go there, and there the teacher comes in the class and teaches the student. Margie was surprised to hear that there was a building where the children used to go and take education. And all the kids learned the same thing? Sure, if they were the same age. But my mother says a teacher had to be adjusted to fit the mind of each boy and girl it teaches, and that each kid has to be taught differently. Now Margie's mother must have told her that each and every boy's age was different, so they were taught according to their ages. Just the same, they didn't do it that way then. If you don't like it, you don't have to read the book. Now, Margie was very much confused as how children can be learned by books in a school taught by a man. So she was having queries with her brother Tom. I don't say I didn't like it, Maggie said quickly. She wanted to read about those funny schools. She wanted to know more about those schools, teachers, and the students. They weren't even half finished when Maggie's mother called. Maggie school. Means they were talking just at the meantime. Maggie was called to go to her mechanical teacher. Maggie looked up. Not yet, Mama. Now, said Mrs. Jones, and it's probably time for Tommy too. Maggie said to Tommy, can I read the book some more with you after school? Maybe, he said nonchalantly. He walked away, whistling the dusty old book tucked beneath her, beneath his arm. Now he means Tommy, went off coolly, calmly, whistling and taking that book under his arms. Maggie went into the school room. It was right next to her bedroom. Where was her school? It was right next to her bedroom, and the mechanical teacher was on and waiting for her. It was always on at the same time every day except Saturday and Sunday, because her mother said little girls learn better if they learn at regular hours. Means every day at regular time she was being taught by the mechanical teacher except Saturday and Sunday. The screen was lit up and it said, today's arithmetic lesson is on the addition of proper fraction. Now the teaching process was going on with Maggie. Please insert yesterday's homework in the proper slot. Now, before moving, the mechanical teacher asked about the homework of the previous classes. Maggie did show with a sigh, means with a relief. She was thinking about the old schools they had when her grandfather's father was a little boy. She was thinking about the old school when her grandfather was a little boy. Grandfather's grandfather was a little boy, okay. All the kids from the whole neighborhood came laughing and shouting in the schoolyard, sitting together in the schoolroom, going home together at the end of the day. They learned the same thing so they could help one another in the homework and talk about it. Now she was thinking all the day, she was thinking about that, how the children used to come together, they used to read or study together and then get back home again together, and if one has any problem they can discuss with each other. They can even share their homework with each other. And the teacher were people. The mechanical teacher was flashing on the screen, when we add the fraction half and 1/4. Now she was going on dreaming while the mechanical teacher was flashing on the addition of the fraction. Maggie was thinking about how the kids must have loved it in the old days. She was thinking about the fun they had. This is all about the heading of the poem, that the fun they had, the fun which the old students had than the Maggie and the then Maggie and Tommy was having, because they are now taught by the mechanical teacher. So this thing may happen in the future, because nowadays you are getting educated by a type of you can say distance education. Now maybe in future the teacher will be replaced by the mechanical teacher and you will be studying there at home only. No need to come to any school or gather somewhere and get education. Rather, you all will be taught by separately, individually in your own home only. So what's the future? No one knows. All of you have understood the story? Is there any problem in it? Any of the word or any of the line, if you haven't understood, you can ask me in your WhatsApp group. your homework will be to find out the meaning of the tough word from the chapter, write the meaning, look into the dictionary, and then from any of the five words you will be making sentences of your own. Any five words from the chapter, you take it and make sentence in your copy. The next class I will be discussing the rest of the question answers, fill in the blanks and all those. Next class you will be having your copies along with you, copy, pen, so that whatever we will be discussing will be written in your copies. Now today's work, whatever I have given you, should be done in the same copy, English copy only. And then it will be preceded by the question answers. If there is any doubt, you can ask me. Thank you, everyone. Have a good day.